Ladies love me. I'm on my cool J. All right, guys. Welcome back to LL Cool Joe. Back with another life lesson. Got a special guest on the line. Calling in from San Fran. Production assistant for the Golden State Warriors. My guy, Terrance Cook. What's going on? So Terrance, the whole purpose of this is to kind of give some insight on careers in the sports industry. And just a little bit of background, like the reason why this is here, how it is because I was in college going into my junior and senior year and I had no idea what I wanted to do. So why not use our platform to talk about what we do and kind of inform people about careers. So with that being said, production assistant for the Golden State Warriors, can you give us a little bit of intel about that?
Yes. First off, thank you for welcoming me on the show. Joe, it's inspiring to see what you're doing. It really motivates the rest of us. Well, production assistant with the Golden State Warriors. First off, I love sports. Grew up playing it my whole life. And being a new, growing up, I always wanted to do the next best thing. If I can't play sports professionally, I would rather work or be close to sports. So first love is baseball, but obviously I'm a fan of all sports. But working as a production assistant with the Golden State Warriors, first off, is a dream come true, especially because Pittsburgh, I'm from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, guys, we don't have a basketball team. And, as odd as that is, we don't have one. Yeah. And so it's exciting. I mean, I grew up a LeBron fan, though, you know, so okay. it's kind of weird, you know, but I respect the Warriors. I respect the business sense, the way they carry themselves. As a production assistant, we do a lot of different things, such as we're setting up for game day, running cameras, running cables, editing footage, constantly shooting different events, such as our corporate partner events, brand marketing. And we have more of a studio-based setting, and so where we are doing schedule release videos for the NBA. We do events such as like Beyond 28 and movements like that to just help create our new goals. And it's fun to watch being there. It's fun to watch. Fun to be around.
That's awesome, man. I also want to applaud you because, you know, When they tell you, me and Olivia were talking about this, like when you say you want to work in sports, they tell you, you got to move here, you're going to have to move here, and you're going to have to move here. And man, you literally have done that. Like you sacrificed so much to go after what you love, man. And you motivate me as well. So I definitely wanted to let you know that.
I grew up in Longview Heights, which is in Whittaker, Pennsylvania, which is West Mifflin. So growing up in that environment, easy to go left, you know, it's a lot of negativity, but the only positive thing that's really going on out of there is people playing sports. And growing up, I've always had a passion for sports. Obviously, as I reiterated, baseball is my first love. I remember I played in the Braddock League, believe it or not, since I was 5 to 12, and just loved it. You know, it's one of those things, bro, where you wake up, and like I said, you play sports, so. It's one of those things where you wake up as a kid and you're like, man, I just can't wait to play our next game. Yep. We're in a championship, and I've always been on competitive teams, and I've known what it's like to not be on a good team, and I know what it's like to be on the best team. But just being always known to be competitive, because anybody can be beat on any day. The resiliency that we learned growing up in the team environment, it teaches you how to be a better team player, but a better man off the field. Unfortunately, in West Mifflin, I didn't really care about school as much. And, you know, I cared more about sports. And one day I seen all my friends, like you said, going off into college, and I really didn't know what I wanted to do. I still wanted to play sports. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, I had to go to CCAC, and excuse me because I said unfortunately, because it's not unfortunate, it's a step. I chose to go to CCAC first, where I spent a year and a half there, really learning how to be a student, because I wasn't really taught that. I didn't really care. So once I learned sports wasn't really my thing anymore, I knew I had to give it up. I just went on and was like, okay, well, I really don't want to be in Pittsburgh anymore. CCAC is cool and all, but that's like, I feel that's like 13th grade. But it helped shape me to a better person, to help me be a better student, which helped prepare me. Mm-hmm. So I went on and I transferred to IUP, and it's crazy. I was working at McDonald's while this was all going.
Oh, wow. Okay.
I was working at McDonald's.
Grinding.
3 years. I was loyal to McDonald's because I was communications media is what I studied. So just messing around with the camera, starting trying to get good, and I started really liking it. But at first, it's be like, oh, this is weak. I suck, you know. But just learning my camera. I remember I took a photography class. And when I took that photography class, I'm grateful I had a teacher who cared. Professor Jungle didn't have to do what he did for the extra time for me, but he made sure that, you know, I learned it and made sure, like, okay, he seen the talent, and I didn't know. Like, I was so naive about it. And so I'm just like, all right, well, how do I get in here? I know I want to make movies. I want to do this, but I can take photos. Yeah, here, look, you just need a little bit of coaching. And if you let me, I can teach you some things and just learn as you go. Mm-hmm. Taught me shutter speeds, the lighting, and what could you do? You know, like, what's the difference? All right, we're in this lighting for basketball. How would you shoot this? If we're in this for this, how would you shoot this? And just like I said, it's getting involved in your major, per se, getting involved, let the people know you. Mm-hmm. And what that brought me is the next following year, I just happened to have a friend that I happened to be on the football team, and he happened to say, my man Kev, he just was happened to, I guess the student the main photographer guy, he was like, eventually happens to be my boss. He goes and he says, hey, we need a photographer. Is there anybody, you know? And ironically, that's when I get the call with the Pittsburgh Steelers that summer. And that's when I'm interning with them and I'm getting to learn everything, bro. And it was phenomenal work for, like I said, that was my dream organization. And being at the age of 21, you're like, whoa, like, sky's the limit. Meeting Mr. Rooney knowing how much he means to the world, not just to the game of football, to the world. And
yes,
for guys like him to even take time out of his day to see how I'm doing. It really touches you and it motivates you. And coming from that mind frame and transitioning that into school and getting into internships, that hunger starts to build. I'm here. I feel like I'm knocking on the door. I can taste it. How can I get in? And that's what the Steelers showed. The guy was like, oh, yeah, Terrance, I just interned with the Steelers. Check him out. Luckily, I got some reels. I put my reels together, made sure everything was right. Now I'm the photographer of the school. Now here's a big title for me, and I get to be all sports media, and all the photography is coming from me. I'm getting published and I'm getting exposure, but all this exposure I wish I would have did when I was a freshman. If I'd have did this as a freshman, I'd probably be in a different position right now. But I like where I am. But that's what made me love the camera and make me go so hard.
Love that. Love that. So after the Steelers, you also had some cool opportunities down the road, man. You looking at your resume is phenomenal to me. What was your next step after the Steelers?
Well, next step after we're graduating IUP, mm-hmm. Where I graduated my bachelor's of science, mm-hmm. and I'm back in the hood, you know, I'm back at home. And I'm like, I don't like my environment. I really don't want to be here. I feel like a failure. But in reality, I got my mom behind me and she's, you know, telling me, oh man, you're not no failure. Let's do this. You can do this and that. After the Steelers, I just got more hungry. I wanted to get more interest. Oh, there's different opportunities to get me up out of here. But I knew I couldn't afford that just coming straight out, going moving to different cities. I can't just straight out afford that. What I'm gonna have to do is use my master's. So I was glad I had some mentors behind me. I used to work at A&L BMW right there in Monroeville, washing cars, but it's not where I need to be. I got a degree, like, where am I at? But I just said, you know what? Take that bet on myself. I'm like, all right, I start looking up grad schools. Who can get me in where they're not really caring about grades. They're caring about projects, you know. So I study my master's. What do they offer? Are they more theory based? Are they more project based? So just doing my research, and I came across a school that is called Academy of the Art, where they it's more project based. It fits my description of how I wanted to learn. I knew I wanted to learn film and movies, and yes, I wanted to go to LA, but something told me just to go to SF. SF was it just clicked. Mm-hmm. And it's wild because I grew up liking like a bear. I used to watch Barry Bonds, you know, San Francisco Giants growing up, because, you know, unfortunately the Pirates wasn't that good for us growing up. So I used to watch them, and like Ken Griffey Jr. was my favorite. Baseball was everything. So I tried to intern with them at first and couldn't get there. I happened to start my grad school in San Francisco, which is one of the most exciting but hardest places to live. If I fail, I'd rather fail going 100 miles an hour than not trying at all. So at this time, I'm starting my label, Terrance Cook Productions, at that time. So right after that, we're flying to San Francisco. I know one friend, found out I have some family here. They're studying my master's in film, where I'm learning under a two-time Oscar winner. Being active, trying to find new jobs, brought me to Oakland Raiders. Oakland Raiders, there I am a entertainment coordinator, production assistant, per se, but realistic, an intern. And, you know, that happened to be Marshawn Lynch's year that he comes. Nice. So I get to meet Marshawn Lynch, interviewing him. Trayvon Hester was on the team at the time. Excuse me. It was just exciting, you know, seeing that's like, I'm like, I'm back in the NFL. I'm good enough to be back here. I haven't been back in about a year and a half, 2 years, but finally something shaking in San Francisco, finally. After the Raiders, I networked my way over to the Oakland Athletics, where just, you know, talking to different people and getting, you know, just being, like you said, that pest, you know, like I said, the pest, and just wanting to learn more. And that's one thing I would tell guys, don't be afraid to learn more. Don't be in there thinking that you know everything. Just explore your mind. You will learn so much more and get so far. Just wanting to learn more, and I started with the A's came, and that was exciting. I'm back in. I'm finally doing baseball, but the baseball grind is way tougher. I would say way tougher than like a NFL grind. Excuse me, because I only say that because it's more games. 82 the wear, games, right? Wear on your body. You got to stay up for each game. You can't just fall. You know, you can't just fall asleep. So yep. The game, there's no time limit. So there's always, you're just, the wear and tear on your body is ridiculous. But yeah, it's fun. It's fun when it's all said and done. After the A's, I get over to the Giants, where I'm learning some more. But I'm still working with the A's. Raiders happen to leave to go to Vegas. So I'm still doing my two jobs, still in school full time. Finally get my master's degree. A year out of my master's degree, the Warriors call. And one thing about the Warriors, I applied to them ever since I came. This is 3 years, 4 years, my fourth year here. Mm-hmm. And I knew one thing. I knew that, like, I was like, I knew if I can get with them, I just want to see how they work. I've heard so much great things, but I want to see how the culture is. I want to see what is it that makes them so great. And when I remember getting that call, it was in the summertime, and I remember they wanted to interview me, and I just said in my mind, let's go. And it's always been like that, but really when that came, I was really saying let's go, because I really was knocking at that door for a while. And just to be in there and be and seeing the NBA, like, we don't have no NBA team, bro. Just to see Steph Curry warming up, you know, you gotta. I still probably get a little starstruck, just a little bit, not as much as I, you know, at first, but
yeah.
Get to like one time, like when I seen LeBron, I was like, oh. Oh, that's him. You know, like that's LeBron, yeah. James. Bro,
probably had to look from the camera like this dude really.
When he ran into me, I have a photo. I'm gonna send it to you where he ran into me, and it's one of the most hilarious photos. just moments like that makes the grind and journey so much worth it. And I started my, like, and being there, it's like, it's not a job to me, which I'm sure it's not a job to you as well. It's, I get to get up, chase my dreams and goals, learn more. And one thing about the Warriors, they want you to learn more. The crew I'm on, from top to bottom, is phenomenal. They are really, really guys who really want to work hard. They really want to put the best product out there, and they want to see you get better. And for other organizations, I can say that wasn't the case, you know, but here they're more like, let's get you better. Here's your strengths and here's your weakness. Let's tackle your weakness. We already know what you can do behind the camera. Let's tackle you with editing more. Let's tackle you with, let's do some more producing. I know you have them, you know, but let's do creative marketing. Let's do, you know, it's fun, you know. So it teaches us to be a lot of, there's really like when there's a, you know, you go to work, you say there's your to-do list. In production, there is no to-do list. Yeah, there's stuff that needs to be done, but things could come up. You may have to hop on another project or go to another shoot. Game is tomorrow. Got to go to a shoot. It's wow. It's phenomenal because we have so many sponsors, and it's phenomenal to see and phenomenal to watch.
Man,
you ask me, I like where I'm at. I like the Bay Area. My dream is LA, though, bro. I'll be honest with you. My dream is LA. I'm gonna get there eventually, but. I love in the Bay. The Bay has been nothing but love. Way more opportunities, but obviously, bro, they got two of everything.
Yeah.
The Bay Area. So you got, they had, come on, two football teams, one hockey, one basketball. They got more, you know, college. Yeah. College is everywhere. So you can get, there's a lot of money flowing into the Bay Area.
Love that, man. You pretty much answer all the questions that I had for you. There were so many gems in there. And it's so motivating too, man, because it's like you can't teach somebody to have hunger. You know what I mean? Either you got it or you don't. You know what I mean? You're taking leaps, you moving everywhere to pursue your passion in sports. You said you want to keep learning more. Like, you can't teach like effort to, you can't make somebody want to chase their dreams. And I really love, like, I'm sitting here like, dang, like you still motivating me, and this is why I wanted to read.
Bro, it's fun. It's amazing. Like, bro, the grind, I've married it. And like I said, I'm nobody super special. You know, like I said, I try to carry myself a certain way, but I am who I am. I'm Terrance, and I'm one of those guys who, I want to see you win. I want to see you do better than me. If I can tell anybody anything, if they wanted to leave, have a backup plan first. Like, don't just be out here and just, oh, I'm going to just take this. No, bro. Don't, please don't do that. But when I figured out education can take you anywhere you want to go without sports, I said, well, if I can't bet on myself, who will believe in me? Who would invest in me? Not hunger, like you say, man, I know what it feels like to be broken. I know what it feels like to have a dream, have every door shut in your way, but you just wanted to learn. But every organization that I've ever been a part of all speaks of me the same way. And that's how I would see with, I would tell anyone, because the production industry, if they're interested in production, the production industry is a lot of referrals. And not one referral, you can really be anywhere. Like, bro, there's times they tell Terrance, you want to work Monday Night Football? What? Yeah, let's go.
Yeah.
Let's go. And, you know, next thing you know, you're next to Todd Gurley, you know, or next to, you know, it's just so many opportunities it brings you. Like, I got an opportunity to go to SoFi Stadium.
I know COVID.
I would say this. The Bay Area is nothing to play with, because this is what I've learned. The millionaires play in L.A. The billionaires play in the Bay.
Yeah. Okay.
Billionaire playing the Bay. I met a lot of phenomenal people just because I'm able, I'm fortunate enough, I'm blessed enough to have the certain access. A moment with E-40, you know, Bay Area legend, to where, you know, I'm a guy from Pittsburgh. And, you know, we grew up, we know who E-40 is, you know, and the respect factor that we have there, and what he means to the community. Just having a one-on-one with him, and the fact that he initiated, mm-hmm. said volumes. You know, one of the things he told me, oh, make sure you keep working, because he's like, I already know you working, because you're the only one I see down here. I'm like, what? And I had to really take it in at first. I was like, oh, just make sure you stay inspired, man. And he's always shown love. You know, every time he sees me, he's never been a fake. He's always been real. You know, he drops gems too. And I try to get it from everybody. You know, anybody that is offering that. And one thing about the Bay, they show a lot of love, bro. I can honestly say that there's a lot of love out here to where you can prevail. If you got that hunger, that work ethic, but they got to match. They got to match. There's just so many opportunities.
Name like just three moments where you just like, wow, or like being starstruck. Because you said LeBron was one of them.
LeBron won. I got you. LeBron won. Ben Roethlisberger on the day that I actually signed with the Steelers, seeing Big Ben and Mike Tomlin. Those two, those moments. Mm-hmm. But my most starstruck moment. That's tough.
If you got two, that's fine.
Mr. Rooney talking to me in the lunchroom and giving me advice about everything and letting me meet in the NHL commissioners and then knowing who I was and introduced them to me like I was a full-time student, like I was a full-time staff.
Love that.
That right there will ever forever sit with my heart, the best one. Interviewing Marshawn Lynch.
was there any profanity in it?
He said
probably not.
Yes. But it was he was actually he's pretty nice, man. He's a pretty nice guy. That moment right there. Interviewing him and he said, what's poppin', boss? What you want, boss? What did they tell you what did they ask you to interview me, boss?
My guy Marshawn. That's dope, man.
That's a wild moment. Just a quick moment with him. You know, that's it.
All right, the last part, man. I see you doing your conversations with Cook, man. I think that's also cool too. You want to tell the people about it a little bit, and if you got any social handles that you want to share for people to follow you.
Absolutely. Conversations with Cook, guys. Everybody tune in. Conversations with Cook is basically a platform such as this to where we're bringing on people from all different varieties, and I want to help them. I want to share their stories with everyone else. For instance, we have people who own nail salons, people who are in the industry of sports, in the industry of film. I have athletes that come on that are in the NFL or have had NFL experience. I want to have like fitness people. It's just a creation of, I want to bring everyone together. My motto is to let's converse with the world. And let's share everyone's story. Everyone has a story, but everyone don't have a chance to tell it. Like I said, guys, so what I'll leave you guys with is live life, have fun while doing it, make your family proud, and do what's best for you.
Yeah.
Thank you, bro, for giving me the platform to help inspire and to help motivate, bro. Trust me, you inspire me, you motivate me. You've always been A1. Guys, tune into his show, man. I'm tuned in. Let's go, guys.
Absolutely, man. Appreciate your time, Cook. We're going to wrap this up. Another life lesson. Man, that was probably one of the best ones.